Hey there, you trying to get over the fear of doing video? Well, in this week's episode, I'm going to share with you four different things that you can use to shatter that fear and start doing video. Hey, it's Michael Creasy here, and welcome to this week's episode. And the content was contributed by our good friend and fellow realtor, Karen Carr, and you can check her out at GeorgiaCoastHomes.com. Now, video, oh my gosh, every trade show I go to, video's the latest and greatest best thing, even though I've been doing this for 10 years. So let me share with you four things to get you started. The first one is, start doing video. Seriously, just hit record and do videos on your phone, on your computer, on your laptop, whatever it is. And these aren't necessarily videos that you have to post. But the more you see yourself and hear what you sound like, see what you look like, the more comfortable you're going to get. I mean, that's the easiest way to start doing video. Hit record, start doing it, and you'll get over that fear. Just like going to a gym, the more you go and work out, the more comfortable you get with going to the gym. Point number two is accept who you are. I mean, if you're 10 or 20 pounds overweight, if you're follicly challenged or a hair donor like me, own it. And what I tell my students is, own it, get over it, move on. Let me repeat that. Own it, get over it, move on. There's no point beating yourself up over what you look like because you are who you are. I would sooner you be an original than some copy of what you think you should be. So be yourself because everyone else is taken. Number three, when you're doing video, make sure you're looking into the lens. So if I'm looking this way and I'm talking to you, well, it doesn't really feel like a conversation. But if I'm looking into the lens, you feel like I'm speaking directly to you. And that's the power of video, looking into the lens and having a conversation with that person on the other side. Because what will happen as they watch your videos, they'll get the sense of they know you. They actually know, like, and trust you. And so when they meet you in person, you're almost like a friend. And you don't have to be a pushy salesperson. That is powerful. Look into the lens. And point number next, when you're going to do a video, make sure you know what the heck you're going to be talking about. You may want to script it out ahead of time, put down some bullet points, so you know what your conversation is going to be, what your topic is. And then more importantly, at the end of that topic, excuse me here, I'm fighting off a cold, what is the call to action? What is the thing that you want the person watching the video to do? Do you want them to pick up the phone? Do you want them to download a report, go to your website? Be clear about what it is that you want them to do. Now, if you give good quality content, you've earned the right to ask something in return. That's called reciprocity. And it could be something as simple as, hey, like this video, leave a comment below. Speaking of which, like this video and leave a comment below. So once again, it's Michael Creasy here. I hope you found this content video. I'm looking forward to you getting over that fear, hitting record, so I can actually see your video. So lights, camera, action. Let's make it happen and do videos.